important news break on this story. All through the day, we saw stock markets getting roiled after Punjab National Bank told exchanges that the loss that they could have, they may have to endure could be around 11,000 crores, and that letters of credit were given, letters of undertaking were given by a branch official, and those were not backed by the bank. They were fraudulent transactions. What we now learn is that the person probably at the center of this, who took advantage of these loans, to whom, against whom the LOUs were given, is Nirav Modi, and he has written to several banks, including Punjab National Bank, as well as to other banks that were involved. And we understand these banks include Allahabad Bank, probably Axis Bank, probably Canara Bank, State Bank of India. He has written to all these banks. Our sources tell us, we have not checked with every bank, but we understand, we have definitely checked with one bank, who bank head, who has got this letter and who therefore told us the contents of this letter. Among the contents are the that he is looking to sell his flagship brand, Firestone Diamond. Remember, Nirav Modi is a fashion jewelry designer with showrooms in several international cities, including Beverly Hills, Hong Kong, Macau, and several Indian cities as well. He has written saying that he's looking for suitors for his flagship brand, Firestone Diamond. He says Firestone Diamond itself can be valued at 6,435 crores. That's what he says in the letter. This is not the personal net worth of Nirav Modi. It is just what he is, says his brand is valued at, and that Nirav Modi will hand over the sale proceeds. It might take him 3 to 6 months to get that kind of money. He promises to repay all dues to lenders from the proceeds of the sale. He says he has going to he's going to give the mandate to an investment banker, and that investment banker will find potential suitors. So this is a very important breaking story, that 10,000 crore fraud may well be smaller, because Nirav Modi says in letters to written to bankers that he intends to pay back.
Absolutely, Lata. So the big breaking story there, Nirav Modi saying that he will pay loans back to the bankers. So that's the big breaking story on the PNB right now. We also have Ritu with us. Ritu, if you could add some more to the story and tell us if you have picked up anything else.
You know, exactly as Lata ma'am was pointing out, the quantum of the scam, at least that much, you know, we can confirm, is over 11,000 crore rupees. And of that, now it boils down to less than 4,000 crore rupees. The proceeds from this sale, as Nirav Modi says in his letter, is about 6,400 crore. So the remaining amount is what remains still in question. The rest clearly can be repaid, given that the value of his flagship brand, that is Firestone Diamonds, is over 6,400 crore rupees. The remaining is what remains, you know, is left in question. But he has given a timeline of 3 to 6 months. Some banks say he may just be biding time, and they wait to see more action to be taken on this front. This is just a letter, as the bankers are saying, and therefore, you know, the other banks are not really worried. As I said earlier, PNB is the one that is a guarantor to Nirav Modi and the other officials, and therefore PNB is the one that has to repay all of these banks that are now involved in this very big scam. So PNB is the one that really has to go after Nirav Modi, ensure this sale happens, and that is something that the other bankers are also you know, waiting to see.
Okay, well, Ritu, maybe you know, there are a lot of people who have just joined us and who have heard that Nirav Modi has written to bankers. Maybe you want to go back and tell us exactly how this fraud was perpetrated. What exactly happened at that Mumbai branch of PNB, where apparently some officials have been suspended?
Well, you know, Lata, there's been no official word from Punjab National Bank, but this is what we have been able to gather from sources in the banking industry, because now, remember, a lot of banks are involved, so this is what they've been saying. You know, Nirav Modi and some of the other officials, including the MD of Gitanjali Gems, Mr. Choksi, colluded with officials of Punjab National Bank, after which unauthorized letters of undertakings were issued, using which Nirav Modi and these officials, you know, got credit from overseas branches of other Indian Indian banks. You name some of them, Allahabad Bank, Axis Bank, Union Bank of India, to then secure credit. This really means is that all of these other banks that have given credit, again, have to rely back on PNB to get it back. How this really works is these LOUs is essentially a letter of comfort and a guarantee that PNB is given that these dues will be honored. This is done through a switch mechanism where SWIFT, both the letters, the LOU is compared with what is presented with the import documents at these banks. And therefore, this money is then transferred to a specific account at Punjab National Bank, which is then used to repay the suppliers, in this case of Nirav Modi. This is essentially how the scam has happened. The PNB officials have managed to keep all of these transactions and activities out of the PNB's bank sheet, which is why so far, for all of these last 8 years, the bank fraud was not really discovered. It's perhaps now when one of the officials has retired that the scam has come to light.
I just wanted to add that bit. It appears that a retired official who went in service along with the connivance of some clerks was managing this letter of undertaking on the SWIFT switch system.
Yeah.
And that merely tells from one branch of Punjab National Bank, it tells other banks that we have done the due diligence. Now you can loan this guy and we guarantee it. But this, the KYC done, all these information is not linked to the core banking system of the bank. Of course, bankers are raising other questions as to if it is not linked, wasn't the branch manager, branch managers at various points in time checking, doing a daily check? What about the concurrent auditor? The branch has been audited several times by concurrent auditors. They are supposed to be the watchdogs. Why did they not discover that these LOUs have been sent and there are no matching transactions or liabilities anywhere else in the bank? So it appears to be an operations failure. As it appears to be at one level complicity, at another level negligence, and at another level probably ignorance. Didn't know that this is how we ought to be checking or counter-checking. So it appears to be a failure at several levels. But what we now know in the last half an hour, and this is the CNBC TV 18 exclusive, that the loss hopefully is not 10 or 11,000 crores, because Nirav Modi has written to the banker saying that he intends to sell his Firestone Diamond, and the brand may be valued at 6,500 crores or thereabouts. So probably the money will be paid. We do not know if it is all the money. We do not know if Mr. Nirav Modi will be as good as his word.
Yes.
But what we know for the moment, and that's the best news that Punjab National Bank has got through the day, that at least a letter has been sent, and the person who has taken these loans is owning up to the loans and saying that he may pay back. We'll have to wait and see when the money comes.
Yes, absolutely, Lata.